Well, it's always good to be number one, except when it comes to our next subject. A new study says that St. Louis is the worst city in the U.S. when it comes to sexually transmitted diseases, or STDs. And we have Dr. Mira Abishan here from the Missouri Center for Reproductive Medicine to talk about the shocking numbers. And my first question for you is, what are the most common STDs being transmitted here in the region?
The most common two infections are gonorrhea and chlamydia.
Mm-hmm. Now, do you think people are just not getting tested for these things, or why do you think these numbers are what they are?
So in St. Louis City, there were about 5,000 cases. Just compare that to other parts of the country, which larger metropolitan areas where the numbers are much higher. So I think what is the take-home message is that there's just more cases per population, per 100,000 people here. And that may be because there's more testing, or it may truly be because there are other factors. For example, perhaps these people are getting reinfected from their partners. I'm not sure that it's clear.
Mm-hmm. So I was gonna say, so when you were looking at the numbers, was there anything else that kind of stood out to you that was interesting about them, or as you kind of sifted through all of them?
Well, I noticed that it was fairly stable from year to year and fairly stable from month to month. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I think that that just reflects the fact that this is a good topic for more education, mm-hmm. especially as to why it's important. And there's many reasons, but I think especially when this is happening to young people, the fact that that could harm their future fertility is just, it's a good thing to educate people about. Mm-hmm.
And when it comes to the STDs, we really don't know exactly what ages are being affected the most, right, at this point?
At this point, I'm not a statistician, but when I read through this, it was not clear to me.
Okay, now when you talk about reproduction, what are the impacts and the effects of this that people can have down the line?
Yeah, and so I would say not everybody that develops gonorrhea or chlamydia will have fertility problems, but when they do, a large percentage of them are traced back to these infections. So these can be problems with the fallopian tubes, where the tubes are damaged, where the lining of the uterus is damaged, where there's scar tissue in the pelvis, and all of those things can affect fertility.
Okay, so when it comes to preventative measures, what would you say?
So I would say education, safe sex, condoms, reduce douching, make sure the partners are getting treated. So I would say that all of these things can be taken preventatively rather than having to face it after the fact.
Okay, and the ages too, as far as when people start their sexual activity as
well. I think that's absolutely important. So I think this education needs to start in early adolescence rather than later.
Okay, thank you very much, Doctor.